All right, Julie, thank you very much. Listen up. If you find a mistake on your credit report, you're not alone. According to a new government study, as many as 40 million Americans have a mistake on their credit report. We all know how important our credit is. Bad credit can prevent you from securing a job, competitive interest rates, and even insurance. Joining us now with more information is Eric Friedman, Director of the Office of Consumer Protection in Montgomery County. Thank you for joining us. Good to have you here.
Good morning.
First question, are you surprised by this number? Maybe 40 million people have a mistake on their report?
Well, unfortunately not. We see many of these complaints in our office. And first, Tony, the thing that many consumers might be surprised about is that there are three major credit reporting bureaus up there in the sky that collect, maintain, and sell personal financial information about you and me and everyone else.
Mm-hmm. To many, many different sources, as a matter of fact, they sell it to. Let's talk about how you find out, number one, if there's a mistake. Now, I must admit, I know about this because I found a mistake in my credit report 2 years ago. And I have to say, my experience was it went pretty smoothly in terms of getting that fixed. I know that's not always the case.
It's not. You were lucky. The Federal Trade Commission issued a 370-page report, and they found basically three things. One is that there are many, many errors on these credit reports. Mm-hmm. Number two, most consumers like you and me don't check our credit report mm-hmm. frequently enough. And number three, it can be difficult, if not impossible, to correct it. You were lucky, apparently.
Yeah, I was lucky. All right. First thing first, how do you find out if you've got a mistake on your report?
Well, number one is go to annualcreditreport.com. There are many imposter websites out there. There are ones that will sell you products. There are ones that are confusing. But the one you really want to go to is the one that the government has set up with the three major credit reporting bureaus, which is annualcreditreport.com. Make sure you spell it perfectly correctly. Make sure it doesn't have the word free in there or the letter S. You just want to go to that one. You can get a free credit report. They won't sell you any of these premium products. Mm-hmm. And then just take a look at it. I tried it yesterday afternoon. Mm-hmm. It took a matter of about 8 minutes, less time than my teenage daughter takes a shower, to go on there, get the credit report, and then just take a few minutes. You know, we check our emails 1,000 times a day. Mm-hmm. We check to make sure our shoes are tied, but it'll be a bigger slip up if you have a problem on your credit report, and you want to find it early, because the sooner you find it, the sooner you can correct it.
But, and I guess the bottom line is here, you do not have to pay to get your credit report.
Absolutely not. You should not pay a penny to get your credit report, and you should do it. You have a right to do it once a year with each of the companies. So mm-hmm. you can do it, you know, every 3, 6, 9 months. And just check it, take a few minutes, sit down, look at it. It will tell you line by line what kind of items are on there, whether you've been late or not, and you'll be surprised how many errors you may be able to find.
All right. If you find an error, then what do?
Contact the Credit Reporting Bureau in writing. They have an obligation to do a reasonable investigation, which some people wonder whether they really do, and then they have to remove it if they can verify it. Mm-hmm. And if that doesn't work, contact the Consumer Protection offices in your area, the Federal Trade Commission, or the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau.
Okay. What types of mistakes might we find on our credit reports?
Well, we had a consumer came to our office. On his credit report, he had a mortgage for a house he didn't own, and there was a car loan listed there for a car he didn't own either. Mm-hmm. So there may be incorrect information. It may show that you're late when, in fact, you were not late. It may show you have an account that you don't have. It may have a misspelling of your name, and it may have some other person's credit on your credit report. Mm-hmm. Tons of problems are potentially out there.
If people go through this process and they have problems, they're not getting a response from the credit bureau or what have you, then what do they do?
Well, then they should call a government agency, and we can try and help them. Some consumers have reported having to sue the credit reporting bureaus to get it corrected.
Really?
Hopefully that will not be necessary, but it's a very difficult process. We kind of see it as a version of financial Lyme disease. Mm. It kind of stays with you forever and ever. Once there's a problem on there, it just keeps coming back.
And it really does. And the other surprising thing, once you do this, is how far back in the past these credit reports go. And I know there's different weight applied to different things, but there's a lot of information on there.
That's right.
Is it common that you could find a mistake on, there are three reports, on one or two of the reports and not on the third, or I mean, it's, you gotta look at all of them, right?
That's exactly right. It's possible. There are three different companies out there. They're all making money. They're for-profit companies, and one may have a mistake and the other one may not. So you really need to check all three of them. But again, you can get it all for free. You shouldn't pay a penny.
Any other point that I've missed that you want to make?
That's it. And just be careful about identity theft. That's also a big problem in this country.
All right. Very good. Eric Friedman, thanks for coming in, sir, to talk about it from Montgomery County.
Thanks.
And we will be hearing more about this in the days ahead, I'm sure. Thank you. Appreciate
Thank you.
It. Allison.
8:22 now. It's a Tuesday morning, and still ahead, his dad received the Medal of Honor, but he stole the show inside the family-friendly ceremony. Plus, Holly is getting into the Mardi Gras.